Dear friends, welcome back to the series on practical illustrations on GST annual returns. This is part 4. In this part, we will be covering three major aspects. One is the outcome of reconciliation of my input tax credits, that is my GSTR 3B versus books versus my GSTR 2A, how to report it in Table 8 of annual returns. And the second aspect we'll be covering about the DRC 03, how to file one in case of liability discharge, another in case of ITC reversal. Third, we will be covering the reporting errors which has occurred in GSTR 1 or 3B, how to be rectified or report in annual returns. Now the first part, GST ITC reconciliation and the impact on and reporting in Table 8 of annual returns. Now, the exhaustive reconciliation that would be required with respect to income tax credits, after the reconciliation process, probably we get the income tax credits which will fall under the major buckets which we have classified here. One is the invoices which would have matched the matched ITC, and the second would be mismatch in the ITC, probably falling into the two aspects of tax amount mismatch, place of supply mismatch, or invoice number and invoice date mismatch, or GST number mismatch. These could be some certain mismatches. In certain cases, taxable value might differ, but tax amount might mismatch. And in certain cases, only the invoices would be reflected in the portal, but that would not be part of my books. So the reasons for that could be, I probably have accounted that in the next year and also availed that in the next year, and some of the credits could be block credits, hence I may not have availed those credits, and also some of the credits might have got grossed up by booking the entry in my accounts. And some of the cases could be the supplier has uploaded it wrongly to our GST and it is not our invoice. And one more case what we have taken here is that the supplier has uploaded the exempt supplies under the B2B supplies, and although there is no tax amount reflected, taxable value would still come and appear there. There could be cases where suppliers have not uploaded the invoices and hence it is only found with my books of accounts. So there could be reasons that they have classified it as B2C instead of B2B. That could be some of the reasons, or some of the suppliers have not uploaded and they have not even discharged the taxes. There could be also one another category, which is my RCM invoices. That is, with the reverse charge, yes, the GTA services, such other kind of RCMs which appear in my 2A. Now let us look at the 2A repo summary, which we have prepared here, and how do we report that in my annual returns. So here is a case we have, for simplicity's sake, we have taken that my 3B and books matches as far as my input tax credits are concerned. However, on reconciling it with my GSTR 2A, these are the various buckets which we discussed and the amount. We will look into the individual computations. So here is a case of all the invoices which have matched my taxable value, my tax amount, everything has matched. So this we have put under one bucket. We have taken another example of mismatches where in some cases, tax amount matches and taxable value, there is a mismatch. In certain cases, taxable value matches but tax amount, there is a mismatch. In few cases, both there are mismatches. That we have taken under this bucket as value mismatch, and we have arrived at the value here. Now, there are these invoices which is reflecting only in portal. As we discussed, some could be the blocker credits. Here there is a purchase of car, and also there are some refreshments or food which has been purchased. So both these are block credits, hence I have not availed them in my books of accounts and in my 3B. So there are these cases only in portal, appearing in portal. Few are not our invoices, and there is an invoice, the credit of which we have taken in the next year, accounted it and taken in the next year. This could be a case of in-transit goods where dispatch has happened in March, but receiving of goods has happened in April. And we also have taken case of bank charges which has been grossed up in my books of accounts, and hence the credits have not been claimed in my 3B. So these are certain examples. And another example what we discussed was, this is a case of exempt supply which the supplier has uploaded under the B2B invoices, however tax amount, there is no values here. The other final case what we discussed was only in books, that is these transactions are there in my books and the supplier has not uploaded these invoices in my 2A. This is a case of the GTA services received and RCM has been appearing as yes. So these are RCM invoices. Thus we get a Reco summary here where matched invoices, mismatches to the minor difference in value, then in only imported we have RCM invoices, taxable values are there, but there are reasons why such invoices are appearing in portal. There are block credits, there are exempt supplies, and there are only in books which is if the supplier is not uploaded. Let us see how to report these in my table 8 of GSTR 9. Now table 8A of GSTR 9 is an auto population of 2A, that is table 3 and 5, which is my B2B invoices, credit notes, debit notes, and the amendments part. However, there would be difference between table 8A and GSTR 2A for the reasons like the supplier has uploaded in GSTR 1 but has not submitted them. So, unsubmitted GSTR 1 data will not travel to my 8A but it will still find place in 2A. Another reason could be place of supply. Let's say if we go out in a state and stay in a hotel there, they will challenge the CGST, SGST of that particular state. But that credit I am not eligible. 8A will not pick that data. Yet another reason is, there was a cutoff date up till which the data from 2A will travel to 8A. So, 1st May 2019 was the cutoff date. So, after that whatever has got uploaded as GSTR 1, that will not be reflected in my 8A. So, these are some of the reasons of difference between 8A and 2A. Now, whatever I have availed in my 3B, that will travel through my table 6 to 8B. As I said, in a case credits available in 2A, we have claimed it in the next year, that is financial year 18-19. Reason being it is in transit goods. So we have not yet received those goods by the end of the financial year. That I would report in 8C. So this is a critical table where the credits pertaining to financial year 17-18, although reflected in my 2A, but I will be availing them in 18-19, so we need to report that in table 8C. Now 8D would be a differential of this, that is what is appearing in my 2A, what I have availed in 17-18, what I have availed in 18-19, so the difference of that will come to my 8D. It can either be positive or negative. Now what does positive mean? It means that 2A is more than my 3B. The reason could be blocked credits or not other invoices, all those reasons what we discussed now. Now, why it could be negative? Negative because I have claimed in 3B but supplier has not uploaded. Okay. So, here is a case we have arrived at the reconciliation of how this figure came in. My books credits which the supplier has not uploaded somewhere around 95,000. However, there are some credits in 2A which is not ours and some of which we have grossed up. Hence, that and deducting from here, and also there is a value mismatch which we discussed, a minor value mismatch that would also be a reason for difference. And finally, when we reconcile this negative figure, we will be able to reconcile and tally with that. Now, out of this positive, so suppose that my 8D is positive, I need to further report whether it is ineligible or it is missed credit. So, whatever is ineligible, like the blocked credits, what we discussed, the car purchase, the food related. So, those things would be blocked and ineligible, and I'll report that in 8F. However, those grossed up credits, that is my bank charges related, which I did not avail at all, so that would be available but not availed, hence that we would be reporting in 8D. So, this is the way how we report the mismatches and the outcome of reconciliation in my table 8. So, however, there are apprehensions as to whenever the credits have not got uploaded in 2A, can we claim such credits or can we not claim such credits? However, if you look at the section 16 of the CGST Act, what it requires is the condition that tax should have been paid to the government. Now, can we say that mere reflection in GSTR 2A, can we say that the tax has been paid, or mere non-reflection in 2A, does it mean that the supplier has not paid its taxes? Well, what we can do is, as far as those credits which is not uploaded by the supplier, probably some reasons could be he has uploaded it as B2C. He has paid the taxes, probably obtaining a confirmation letter from the supplier with regard to that he has discharged his taxes can help us save these credits and avail it without further reversing it. So probably this is one perspective which we can look at, how to safeguard our credits per se. Now let us come to the second part of today's video, which is how to find the BRC03, the outward supply related liability or RCM liability, where we use the drop down annual return, or it could be the ITC reversal part where we will choose section 73(5). So let us look into the practical aspect of it in the portal. So we have here the user services. If we want to go for a fresh application, we will file it as my applications and a fresh application would be created. For the ease of demo, we have already saved an application, so we will access it through the my saved applications part. So here it is intimation of voluntary payment, that would be the drop down. So we are just trying to see what the data is filled in. So the cause of payment is annual return, and the section would be section 73 subsection 5, and the financial year 17-18 we have chosen here for the period July to March 2018, specific categories of taxes we have selected here for the specific months: IGST, CGST, SGST. Just for the demo purpose, we have made the transaction, minor value transaction. However, we have already deposited this into the cash ledger using the regular means, how we deposit for the 3B purpose. So here we have the cash ledger balance, which now I use this cash ledger balance to offset my liability. So I've mentioned the reason here. Now we can also preview this. We get a PDF draft mode and we can file it. So we will submit with EVC. The BRC03 has been filed. We can click here to download the BRC03 whatever has been filed. So this is the final. So we get an ARN for this as well. So this we can keep a track of what we have discharged through annual return. Now the other mode of discharging the ITC reversal part would be, so here again we go to the user services, my application. So we'll create a fresh application here. It is intimation for DRC03 here again. We'll make a new application. The same procedure we need to follow, except that in case of ITC reversal, here instead of annual return we will choose voluntary, because through annual returns I cannot reverse the ITC. Hence voluntarily under section 73(5) I will be reversing. So this is the only difference part as far as DRC03 filing is concerned in comparison with the liability discharge and the ITC reversal. Now let us move to part 3, reporting errors. There could have been the cases where taxable value has been reported wrongly. That is, my taxes are perfectly matching, but due to typo error, instead of typing the turnover value or the taxable value as 1 lakh, in 3B it has gone as 1 crore. So this difference I was not able to rectify in the forthcoming months at all. So in my annual return, what I will do is, since taxes have been discharged appropriately, only the taxable value, the correct values of 9 lakh, I will enter in my table 4B. Let us do a case, look at a case 2 of mismatch with respect to exempt supply transactions. That is, this is given as an example for those cases where tax, it will not have any impact on the taxes, but the values pertaining to the value of the supplies would not be reported. For example, if we look at this exempt supply case, In my GSTR 1, 81,50,000 has been reported. In my 3B, 81 lakhs has been reported. However, the actual value as per books is 83 lakhs, which has not yet been corrected. So what we can do is, in annual return, the correct values of 83 lakhs needs to be reported in table 5D. This will not have any repercussions on the tax payment part. However, this will lead to the correct reporting. Now let us see a case of ITC reporting errors. Actually, I had imported some goods and I had paid IGST at the time of bill of entry. So my books has import of goods. However, while reporting in 3B, I reported it under the head import of services, that is table 482 of GSTR 3B. Again, an inadvertent error. But the IGST, the transaction has got reflected under the correct credit ledger, that is IGST itself. So this being the case, since it is reflected in the correct credit ledger, only a reporting error. So in my annual return table 6, I will report it appropriately under import of goods. The auto population would come here as import of services, but I will remove that and rectify it in my annual return and place it under the appropriate heads. Now final case, let us look at the reporting errors. What has occurred is, in my 3B, I have claimed a credit of 1,85,000, which is net of credit notes. So my actual credit is 2 lakhs. There is a credit note worth of 15,000 and I have reported it on a net basis in 3B, that is 485 of GSTR 3B. Actually, you know, ideally I should have reported it as 2 lakhs under 485 and reversed under 4B to 15,000. Now what I can do in annual return is, it is, you know, this is my perspective or opinion of how to, you know, address this issue. What I can do in my annual return is, I will report here the entire 2 lakhs in my table 4B instead of 1,85,000, and I will also show a reversal of 15,000 in my table 7H. Thus, I will be rectifying the reporting error which I did during my GSTR 3B filing. So friends, we thought this series of practical illustrations on annual return will probably help you and give a practical perspective of what data needs to be filled, how to handle the mismatches. We have covered in the four parts almost all kinds of mismatches that would have occurred. I hope you have found this video series as useful. So we really thank you for watching us